What is up, everybody? Jester here, and man, it feels great to be back in No Man's Sky playing new content, doing meaningful things. That's right, Expedition 12 Omega has dropped, and there's plenty of new stuff to take a peek at, but I'm also going to add in some tips and tricks for you when you start your version of this expedition. They're going to help you a lot more going forward with it. Tons to talk about. Let's get right in. Most of this new content is centered around the anomaly. As you can see in the middle here, between the Nexus and the Quicksilver Vendor, there's a new little kiosk. This has everything to do with expeditions, and it's really, really cool. When you access this terminal, you're met with this brand new screen, and this is the new replacement for how we used to have to access expeditions. Before, you have to go and do a new save, and then you would select expedition as your difficulty, so to speak. And then you would have rewards available across all the different saves that you have. Now on your main save, you can just come right to this terminal and access everything from here. And this is where they did the thing that I think is really, really cool. What they've done here is allow you from your main save to put things into these slots that you can then access as you get into the expedition. The only caveat is you've got to get up to the anomaly in order to get access to these. So there's probably still going to be things to do on planet before you can get here. But as soon as you do, as long as you've got space, you have access to 8 tech and 24 cargo slots. But what should we bring? For our 8 technology slots, I selected these. Now, I do want to point out, I'm only doing one of each of these. When you go in, make sure you've got 3 of each of them, if not more. 3 will get you fully upgraded around the different things you have installed, and then more you can just sell for nanites. But for the case of this example, for the Starship, I decided on the shield modules, hyperdrive modules, and the positron module. Now I can fight, jump, and live with my ship. I feel pretty good about that. Exosuits, life support module, and then movement. That way we have a little longer jetpack, and we don't have to recharge our health quite as often. With the multi-tool, the mining beam, we also did the scanner module, and then, of course, for me, it's the neutron cannon. This thing is absolutely OP, and I love it. So these are the 8, and I think that's gonna get us really easily through this expedition. As far as our cargo goes, a lot of these were no-brainers, but having 24 slots, it gives us a little bit of leeway. The no-brainers for me are carbon, oxygen for life support, sodium for not only your hazard protection, but also for starship shields, uranium for your launch thrusters, pyrite for your pulse engine, dihydrogen, you're always gonna need jellies for something, so just have some of that with you. Ferrite dust is metal plating, and then I thought, I always end up needing wiring looms, and they're fairly expensive, so let's just bring some of those with us. And warp hypercores. Now our exosuit and our ship are completely covered, resource free for the whole expedition. That should be pretty good. You always need a little bit of cadmium, emerald, and indium, because you never know where they're gonna make you install those. So you wanna have that. You can save a space here by just bringing copper, but I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit of chromatic metal with it as well. Silver and gold, again, you always need them for a little bit of something. Same with cobalt, and then frost crystal, because they always want you to build glass. Now, looking ahead in the experimental, I realized they want you to get a Sentinel fighter. So I wanted to streamline that just a little bit with some shards and some mirrors. And then I kind of got cheeky with my last selections. I had these expansion units laying around for exosuit, multi-tool, and starship. So this is just gonna help us have all the storage we need pretty much everywhere. And then also a moneymaker, stasis device. I have these, I have the farm for it. No reason not to bring it. With all this done, it's time to jump in and let's see what we're getting into with the actual expedition. And I want to be completely honest here. At this point, I'd already started on my main save. So this is actually footage from a creative save that I did, that I went in and, but the expeditions work the same. They don't really work as creative mode, but they kind of do. I'll get to that in a second. But just start collecting all the different resources. You guys know what to do. Start scanning animals, scanning plants, everything you can do. And this will help you along the way. There is exobiology on your very first planet. There's 6 plants. So you will definitely get that done right on your first planet. Mission accomplished for phase 1. What I didn't realize was when I got up to the anomaly and went back to the terminal, they actually added a little something more. And this is where you would have been able to recover all the technology and cargo and start putting that in inventory. But something else caught my eye here, even on this creative save. And that is equipment synthesis. Now, basically on this creative, I'm flying the Radiant Pillar because it's a brand new save, and this waveform focuser is actually my multi-tool. So if you go into that and you look, you can actually clone your main save ship. This means for me that I could have had my main Utopia Speeder, and I could have had the Gravity Entangler, And on my save, it was 6,000 nanites. What this tells me is we're not going to need upgrades for the multi-tool or for the Starship because it's a direct clone with all the upgrades in it. This changes everything about how we've done this. So let's go take a look. And when I said that creative mode does kind of work on this, you can go into the difficulties and you can start to do a few things here. You can't make everything free, so they're not just going to give you everything. But there are some options that you have that you can make things a little easier, things a little tougher if you'd like to. So now with this new information and knowing that we need 6,000 plus nanites, because we're still going to have to buy recipes and things to unlock different stuff for our exosuit, we got to figure out how to get that done. And I feel like there's three major ways we can do that. The first of those three methods, I think, is going to be runaway mold. Now, I don't think this one's going to be very effective because it's just not a good yield. You're only getting about 2,000 nanites per stack. And as you saw, we were pretty set on what we brought with us. If you wanted to make some changes to that and bring three or four stacks of this, then so be it. And you could process those down in 20 minutes and you'd have all the nanites you need. But I think there's a couple of better options. Another option, but it's going to be really hard to come by, is going to be tainted metal. Because you get a 1-2 return on this, which means that stack's going to get you 18,000 plus nanites. It's going to take a little time, but you're going to have everything you need when you get that done. The problem is how hard it is to come by, because you got to go do derelict freighters, and it just doesn't accumulate that fast. But this one, if you have it, really good way to just put one thing in your inventory. This could be a 1-1 flip for that chromatic metal, and you won't have any problems having all the nanites you're going to need to get that done. And that leaves us with the third and what I think is going to be the most effective option for you. Knowing we don't need to upgrade our ship, nor do we need to upgrade the multi-tool, we can now use those six slots that we had slated for those upgrades for something else. And that other system is going to be X-Class upgrades. Now, I did a whole video on this. It's in the top right corner. But basically, just come over to the contraband agent, and what you're looking for is the tech and the arms. And you buy all of these. So make sure you got units to do so. And then we're going to open those up and we'll get X-Class upgrades. I do also want to note that if you come over here and you have tainted metal, you can actually talk to these scrap dealers. And once you get into their actual inventory, which is purchase old scrap, they actually usually have some tech and some arms. But again, tainted metal is very, very hard to come by. Once you get a couple of stacks in your inventory, just go to any old space station vendor and interact with them. And you're going to be able to sell these directly to them. Just go up and hit the sell tab. As you can see, I've got 3,805 and 3,234. That's over 7,000 already, just in two stacks. But that would still give us four slots for technology. So if you wanted to bring even more, you could sell those and make more nanites. Or you could bring other things like maybe hazard protection, particularly in an X-Class, because that is more encompassing than the individual ones that the S-Class does. But like I said, this is easily the best method, and I'm very, very happy to have found it and share it with you guys. One other little point that I found as I was getting into my playthrough, and that is you cannot duplicate technology. You can still duplicate cargo inside the expedition, but technology does not show up. You can't put it in a refiner and do that method anymore. So I'm sure somebody's gonna figure out a way to do that before too long, but just know to bring a full stack of 10, because even though you only need three on like the life support and the movement modules, you can still sell the other seven and make even more nanites. That's just going to get you closer to your goal of having your very own ship and your very own multi-tool playing this expedition. And I think that's going to increase the enjoyment. I'm very thankful for this update. I think they did a pretty good job with this. I was really hoping for something bigger since it had been so long. But as long as they keep feeding new stuff, I'm going to keep playing because I love the game and I'm going to keep making content. If you guys are here for it, hit thumbs up, like the video, subscribe to the channel, because we're going to keep going and just doing everything we want to do. But until next time, folks, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you real soon. Bye.